Hey everyone, today I'm starting a new video series about RFID. The next few videos will focus on 125 kilohertz RFID, also known as low frequency RFID. I'm still learning, so feel free to correct me in the comments or on my Discord server. Let's get started. So RFID stands for radio frequency identification. There's different kinds of RFID. In the next few videos, we're going to focus on low frequency RFID, which is 125 kilohertz. There's also 134.2, but the flipper does 125. Next is high frequency or NFC, which is at 13.56 megahertz. And then there's ultra high or UHF, which is 860 to 960 megahertz. And there's even super high, which is 2.45 gigahertz. So a lot of times when we say RFID in the flipper world, we really mean 125 kilohertz low frequency RFID. In general, LF, HF, and UHF antennas have different form factors. So if you shine a bright light through your card, you can maybe figure out what technology it's using. But there's also some other form factors where this isn't as obvious. Low frequency RFID can be used for access control, where you have a card and then you put that against the reader. It sends a signal to the door controller. The door controller looks up the card in the database, and then it chooses to open the magnetic lock. RFID can also be used in hobby projects. The EM4100 tags give 40 bits of data, and then our .NET application can do whatever we want with it. So over on our flipper, we'll go into 125 kilohertz RFID, and we have read, saved, add manually, and extra actions. We'll go into read. And now it's reading between ASK and PSK. Put our card against it. You can see this was an H10301. Our facility code is 101 or 65 hex. And our card is 29649, 73D1 hex. Under more, we have save, emulate, and write. And when we choose save, it'll create an automatic name. We can change that name if we don't like it. Nameless passage. Go ahead and save that. For emulate, it will start to act like that card. Let's read the card. And our reader just read that card number. Next, we'll go to write, and I'll use this T5577 tag against the back of the flipper. And now we have a key fob we can use. Next, let's take a look at saved. We'll go down to that file we saved, nameless passage. And now we have some more options. We can go to info and we'll see that same information with that 73D1, our card ending in 649. But then we can go into edit. And this is pretty interesting. And you're able to press up twice. And now you can move left and right and then up and down to change a number. So I'm changing it to a D2 instead of a D1. This save is actually a rename of the card, so you can choose to rename it if you'd like. And now when we load this and we go down to info, you'll notice the card ends in 650. Cards are typically issued sequentially, so this card number would represent the next person in line. Here's a typical box of cards you'd buy from HID, and you can see there's a range of cards. A company typically buys the same facility code, but that's a 1-byte value, so there's only about 250 codes worldwide. Next, we have add manually, and you can see all the different protocols for the low frequency RFID that the flipper supports. So these are different encodings. We'll go ahead and do the H10301, and you can see in here, it's just enter the hex data that you want. As we saw, you could convert that decimal data written on a badge into hex data if you had a picture of somebody's badge. And then once you make those edits, you're able to go ahead and save that badge. Extra actions just lets you specify what to read. In custom firmware, there may be additional things like T5577 support. I connected my flipper to my PC. I'm at LabFlipperNet. I click on apps to load all the different applications that are available in the hub. Then I'll click on RFID. And then I will choose the RFID fuzzer application. The description for this application is really good. We'll go ahead and click install to install it onto our flipper. But this talks about everything you need to know for how to use the application. So we'll go into apps, and then we'll scroll down to the RFID folder, and then we'll do the RFID fuzzer. And you can use left and right to pick which one. We're going to use the H10301. And the default values, the BF, the load. So for load, we'll say nameless passage. And you can see we can choose the starting UID. So we'll go ahead and down that a couple. So time delay is 0.4 seconds between signals. And EMT is half a second of signal. I'll go ahead and click OK to start attacking. And you can see those IDs are changing. There's also load UIDs from file if you had a list of IDs you wanted to try. BF customer ID sends one number, keeps changing, and the rest of the bytes stay zero. And then default values are some really common values that can be used, that people use, such as FFFF1111222. So these are good to make sure that no default values are being used. So I mentioned earlier how these keypads usually talk to a controller. In this case, I'm connecting the white, green, and black wires directly into my flipper, and I'm running the Wigan app. So the Wigan app is able to show us the raw data that gets sent. And so you can see we have a 101.29.649. And when I scroll down, you can see that that facility code and the card number match. This is super helpful to see what the reader's actually sending to the door controller. Please like and subscribe. In future videos, we'll look at the more technical aspects of low-frequency RFID.